Hi there, it's Marlene Hillema from ImageMaven.com. Welcome to part two of Simple Image Editing Techniques for Total Beginners. In this video, I'm going to show you how to rotate and flip your photos and to adjust exposure. If you need to see part one again, here's the link to that. Okay, let's get going. So I'm in iPicky.com and I want to go to Photo Library and Upload Photo. And I'm going to navigate to a photo on my hard drive. And there it is. Now you can see from this photo that it's a little bit crooked. This is really easy to do, especially with a point and shoot camera, because we often hold these cameras away from our bodies. Sometimes it's hard to hold them perfectly level. So what we need to do in this case is to straighten the horizon. So we're going to the Rotate and Flip tool under the Basic Tools in iPicky. Click that, and I'm just going to give you a quick run through. You can rotate your photo 90 degrees, you can mirror it left right, and you can mirror it top bottom. But if you have a little bit of a crooked horizon, you can just use this slider, and when you do that, a grid pops up, and that helps you line up parts of your picture on a grid. Now in this case I have a horizon, but I also have a fence in the foreground. And sometimes you get distortion in your lens, so it's hard to find a straight edge. But in this case, I think I'm going to go for the fence because it's more in the foreground. So I'm going to kind of do a compromise here. I'll leave it like that. And when I'm happy, I hit apply. Now you might notice here it says 2.8. That represents the angle, so 2.8 degrees. If I go this way, you notice that it gets a negative angle. So this is 2.8 degrees. And I'm going to hit apply. Now, if you want to zoom into your photo, see down here it says 34%. If I wanted it to fit the screen, I just click this little icon here and that'll fit the screen. And if I want to zoom into the actual pixel size, I just hit 1:1 and that gives me the image at the actual size that it is, at the pixel dimensions that it is. If I want to zoom in closer than 100%, I can do so, but when you do that, you notice that you get little jaggedy edges on your photos. And what that is that I'm looking at the photo larger, I'm zoomed in closer than the actual resolution of the image. It might be hard to see, but if you look down here, it says 458%. The highest I can go is 800%, and when you do that, you can really see the jaggedy edges along the diagonal lines. Now I'm just going to go back to 1:1, and that's at actual size, and then now just clicking it to fit into the window. Okay, so that's rotate, flip, and a little bit of zooming. Let's move on. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the exposure correction. So we uploaded a photo that was a little bit too dark, so I'm going to click on exposure. Now the exposure tool has many parts to it. It has just overall brightness change, okay, and it has highlights, so it just affects the bright areas. It has a shadow, so it makes the shadows darker, and it has contrast, and contrast changes the brightness levels between the dark areas and the bright areas. So this picture overall is a bit too dark, so I'm going to brighten it up. And now I'm just going to brighten up the highlights, the bright areas. So if I slide that across, and now I'm going to keep the shadows a little bit darker, so the dark areas are going to be a little bit back to their original. And now, if we click AB up here, we get a before and after. So you can see that I already brightened up this picture quite a bit. I'm going to even push it further. There we go. Nice. That looks great. So can see that we've really brightened up this shot. Let's push the highlights a little bit more. And that's probably about as far as I would push it. Let's see if changing the contrast does anything. And we kind of have to be careful here. When you change the highlights and shadows a lot, you automatically change the contrast as well. So you don't want to lose too much detail. Let's see that before and after. You can see that the bottom of our photo went a little bit too bright, so maybe I'll just pull that back a tad. There we go, that looks good. Now, there is a feature in here where you can erase part of the effect you did. So in other words, you preserve some of the original exposure of the photo. And I noticed that the tool doesn't work. In theory, there you go, you can see that I painted in the bottom of the photo. I painted back the original, and if I click AB, you're gonna see that. However, it doesn't stick. Watch this. So I go apply. It took out the dark at the bottom that I just added, and it closes the tool. You might have missed that. Let's see that again. So there is a little bug in iPicky in this tool. Hopefully they fix it and you'll be able to brush back some of the original exposure in future updates. Well, I hope this quick iPicky tutorial will help you with rotating and flipping your photos as well as adjusting exposure. Next up, we're going to be talking about color, hue, and saturation. Stay tuned. I'll post the link as soon as it's ready. Thanks for watching. It's Marlene from imagemaven.com. Please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate your support.